Whatever statin for non-cardiac surgery. See, 5% of patients develop cardiovascular events in 30 days after non-cardiac surgery. Small trials have some benefit of statin prior to non-cardiac surgery. So VISION was a trial, large trial, 15,000 patients, consecutive patients with age more than 45 who were undergoing non-cardiac surgery were studied. Mean age was 68. This patient had some or other form of cardiovascular risk factor, and low risk patients were 36%. These patients were receiving some form of cardiovascular therapy also. So it was a multi-center prospective cohort study. Matched population was compared, and those patients who had received statin at least 1 week prior to the non-cardiac surgery were included. 2,800 patients here were compared with matched population not receiving statin, almost 4,500 patients. Follow-up was for 1 month. So primary efficacy endpoint was composite of all-cause mortality, myocardial injury after non-cardiac surgery or stroke at 30 days. What was the outcome? Statin was significantly better if you give preoperatively when it was started at least 1 week before the non-cardiac surgery. This p-value was highly significant. Primary composite outcome was significantly better with statin. All-cause mortality was less, cardiovascular mortality was less, and myocardial injury during non-cardiac surgery was also significantly less with statin. So message from this trial was that among patients undergoing non-cardiac surgery, pre-operative statin therapy was independently associated with lower risk of cardiovascular outcome at 30 days. These results require confirmation by large randomized trial. This was something like a registry with matched population which were compared. It was not a randomized trial. There are two registries which were discussed in recent conferences. One is about hypertrophic obstructive cardiomyopathy. See, we know that about 70% of patients who are having hypertrophic cardiomyopathy have obstructive element. About 20 to 25% of Asian and Japanese have cavity of retention, that is what we call apical cardiomyopathy, and 10% have mid-ventricular obstruction.